It's taken a staggering 269 days, but tonight Victoria is officially COVID-free. There are no active cases after our last patient was cleared, paving the way for more borders to reopen. Mark Santomartino with the developments.
Professor Rhonda Stewart's team treated Victoria's first COVID patient and hopefully our last.
There's a few high fives. Yeah, no, we're just really happy. This is what our job is.
Infected among Chadstone's Butcher Club cluster, the man in his 90s and his wife battled for more than a month in hospital. Victoria's final two active cases. She was discharged last week. He was cleared last night.
It was exciting. You know, it was low-key celebrations. We didn't think they might make it, but they did, which was great.
Today's 000, no new cases, deaths or active infections, is a milestone the state hasn't seen since February. After Melbourne's first wave, active cases dropped as low as 40 in June, before roaring to a peak of 7,880. Stage 4 lockdowns were already in place, helping stop the spread to a total of 20,345 infections. 819 people paid with their lives. It's now been 25 days with no new cases.
Every single Victorian can be proud of the part they've played in defeating the second wave, but 25 days of zero is not the same as having a vaccine.
Vaccine or not, these boards at the airport will fill up, with Queensland set to follow New South Wales and reopen to Victorians in a week, if our mystery cases stay under control.
That if they reach that 28 days tomorrow, then they too will be open on the 1st of December.
Freedom worth celebrating, but carefully. Cynthia Dawes took every precaution, but was still infected in August and continues to suffer fatigue.
I guess my concern is that people become a little cavalier about it. It's not as simple as somebody gets it and they die or they recover. There's a whole lot of people who have ongoing symptoms.
I would love to say we won't see any new cases. I think that is unlikely given what's happening around the world.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.